Hello everybody, my name is Zsolt Szilagyi. I am a guitarist from Finland. I play guitar for a power metal band called DREAMTALE and also more of a rock band called Frozen Factory. I also have this project called After Infinity, where I write the songs, play the guitar, play keyboards, stuff like that. So, I was asked to name four inspirational albums of my life, and these are not favorites, these are just inspirational albums that somehow changed my life. Let's get into it. I'm gonna start from my childhood, or my teenage years. My parents listened to a lot of heavy metal and rock music like Deep Purple, Black Sabbath, Pink Floyd, and Whitesnake as well. This album is called Whitesnake by Whitesnake, also referred to as 1987. It has all the great songs like Still of the Night, of course the great hit Here I Go Again, Looking for Love, Crying in the Rain, Is This Love? There's just no bad song on this album. So this was one of those first albums that really got me into rock and metal. There are many albums that I could name from that time of my life, but I chose Whitesnake because I listened a lot to this album, and I also went to my first big rock concert with my parents in 2006. I remember David Coverdale was given a rose from the audience, and he held up that rose during Is This Love. He looked in the eye of the person that gave the rose to him, and he sang This Must Be Love. And oh, that was such a sweet moment. At that time I was listening to a lot of hair metal and glam metal. I also stumbled upon Guns N' Roses. Well, the first albums, they were pretty simple hair metal. When they released the Use Your Illusion albums, 1 and 2, I'm gonna treat them just as a double CD album. When they released that, they kind of had these songs that were longer, like The Civil War, Estranged, November Rain, Coma, you know, these 7, 8, 9 minute songs. Suddenly they weren't doing those, you know, verse, chorus, guitar solo, chorus, end the song. They were doing something different with the structures of the songs. And that really changed, to me, what you can do with music. You don't have to stick to those simple structures that most of the songs have. You can explore different kind of stuff. You can make 10-minute songs, 15, 20 even. That changed my life. And I started to explore what other bands are doing this. What I found was Dream Theater with their album Images and Words. First song that caught my attention was Another Day, which is really basic structure-wise. But, you know, that caught my attention, and then I checked out their other songs and found out that, damn, you know, there's Metropolis where the song structure is just crazy, and there's this middle section that is just crazy. You know, the guitar and keyboards are going crazy, unison runs, and there are weird rhythmic stuff going on. Keeps you coming back to the song. You know, with these simple songs, you can listen to them only so many times, you get bored of them. But when you have these weird structures and stuff going on, you always find something new, even after 100 times of listening to that song. So yeah, from those bands I learned that you can do crazy stuff. Only your imagination is the limit. For this fourth album, I don't have a physical copy, because we live in the Spotify era, I think. Anyway, I joined DREAMTALE in 2019, and you know, DREAMTALE is very simple power metal, no weird structures. I used to go to rehearsals with our keyboard player Axeli a lot. In his car we would listen to music, whatever he had in the CD player. In the summer of 2020 he had a CD from Beast in Black called From Hell with Love. And Beast in Black, they are really also doing very simple stuff, you know, just like DREAMTALE. I also discovered Arion at that point, and so this Finnish simple but powerful metal, I was introduced a lot to that. It kind of drew me back from those, you know, crazy structures to these simple, powerful songs where you can concentrate on how well the drums are played and produced, and the guitars just sound crunchy, and the vocals are just amazing, and you can, you know, just concentrate on the music, how good it sounds. Not just, you know, the songwriting and song structure, but how well it is produced and how well it sounds. I guess at that point I kind of figured that before you go to that crazy direction like Dream Theater, you need to get your basics really well done. You need to figure out what are those guitar riffs that sound good and work well, and, you know, have those beautiful melodies, chord progressions. After you have established the basics, then you can go on and spice it up with all the crazy stuff. But don't do it just because you want to make crazy music. First, make good music, then spice it up with some craziness. So that's what I learned from Beast in Black. All right, that was my 4 inspirational albums. Thanks for watching.